taking responsibility for your journey in learning to become a programmer and why it's important. Let's talk about that in today's video. Welcome back. My name is Tim Buchalka with another programming tip of the day, and we're talking about taking responsibility for your success and or failure in your journey to become a programmer. And really, this applies to anything in life. Now, the reason this is coming up is that recently, and I'm not going to go into specifics, but I've had someone who's been trying to learn to become a programmer, taking one of my courses, and they've been quite abusive to the people who are trying to help them, quite abusive in general to anyone who's done anything to try and help them, you know, answer their questions and so on. And again, I'm not going to go into any more detail than that, but it made me think today that this is a case of a person who's taking no responsibility for their success. They're looking for quick solutions and they're looking to blame others when really, in situations where you're not succeeding in any aspect of life, I think you need to start looking internally and try and think, you know, what am I doing wrong here? Why aren't I learning? You know, what's the lesson here? So I think in that scenario, this is a person who is not really picking up on the fact that he's got an issue with not actually going through and learning the materials. So he's looking for shortcuts is what ultimately that comes back to. And I think it's really important when you go into a course, learning how to program and go into the whole, you know, journey of becoming a programmer, take ownership of it. And so really sort of say to yourself, well, like, it's up to me. If it's going to be, it's up to me. So in other words, I need to make this work. So we can't really look to blame other people for our lack of success. And it is easy to do that. I mean, it's very easy to, as a human, to look there and think, oh, that course should have taught me how to do that. Or, you know, why isn't this computer fast enough? Or whatever it is, there's always things to look at and blame. But really, we need to come back and look at ourselves and think, okay, what do I need to do here to change? So if you're getting bad results from learning how to program, or if you're finding that things are too hard, what needs to change? Is it the course? And if you look at a course and it's got like thousands or tens of thousands of people who have completed it and are happy with it, and you're not happy with it, the chances are fairly high that the issue is with you. I mean, it's very blunt, it's straight to the point, but I think you do need to hear that if you're in this situation where you're looking, you know, you're annoyed and you're frustrated and you're looking to blame someone else for your problems. It's not to say that you need to give up, certainly not. I'm not advocating you do that. What I'm saying is just realize and accept the fact, okay, I'm the problem here, I'm not getting something, and what can you do to change? Because there's an old saying that goes along the lines of, and if you do the same thing every day and expect different results, then that's the definition of insanity. So in other words, if you're getting stuck in a particular area of life or a particular video or whatever it is, and you're doing the same thing day in and day out, so in other words, maybe you're doing the same type of study, you're watching the same video for the same amount of time, whatever it is, then maybe you need to change what you're doing to get better results. Because doing the same thing, it hasn't worked in the past, chances are probably high that it's still not going to work. So be mindful of that. If you're getting increasingly frustrated and you feel you're not making progress, to actually just take a step back and think, okay, what am I doing wrong here? What can I learn? What can I change with my current habits to try and get a better result? And by all means, use the Q&A section of a course if we're talking about learning how to program. Speak to an instructor or a helper or someone there. Ask a question and see if you can get some input and get you back on track. And speaking of questions, in tomorrow's video, I'm going to talk to you about something very important, and that's the right way to ask a technical question and why that's important both when you're learning how to program, but also in your future career as a programmer. But more on that tomorrow. Alrighty, so I hope that helped. If you've got any questions, feel free to leave a comment and I'll get back to you. If you're ready to look at the next tip, click on up here and you can check that out. If you're interested in coding specific programming videos, click on the link in the bottom left hand corner. Consider subscribing by clicking on the link up here, and I'll see you soon.